Somewhere in almost every episode of The Adventures of Superman, there's a moment when Superman's secret identity as Clark Kent is in danger of being exposed. It might be a simple slip of the tongue, or it might be a deliberate attempt on the part of Lois Lane to expose the secret she is so sure lies hidden under Clark Kent's plain gray suit. And there's that moment in Panic in the Sky when Kent, suffering amnesia, comes close to performing the big reveal himself. Fortunately, Clark or Superman always manages to explain the moment away and to keep his secret literally under wraps. Fortunately, I say, because as we all know, if the secret ever got out, it would spell disaster for those he cares about the most. Reading through the script for Superman and the Mole Men, I found this interesting notation, and that got me to thinking about the many times Superman, or Kent, made a conscious decision to have a little fun with his friends, to tell them his secret without really telling them. There are more of those moments than I had first thought.
Oh, Miss Lane, aren't you going to call your number?
I just remembered it. Thank you, Mr. Kent.
You're welcome, Miss Lane.
Where have you been? And what are you doing in that outfit?
Oh, hello, Lois. This is Dr. Reed. Miss Lane, how do you do, Miss Lane?
Do you know what happened? They shot one of those little monsters.
Dr. Reed just removed the bullet from his chest. He's in there.
In there?
Mm-hmm. Superman brought it to the hospital.
Well, then you know about Superman.
If I don't, who should?
I've got to check the ward now, Mr. Kent. I'll keep an eye on it. Unless I get fired.
You won't, I'm sure.
Glad to meet you, Miss Lane.
How did you leave here later than we did and beat us to the airport?
Is that all?
Not quite. How come you found the man behind the hangar at just the right moment to get his exclusive story when every top experienced reporter in the business was breaking his neck?
Or her neck.
Or her neck to get that story.
Maybe I'm a Superman, Miss Lane.
It's a ruby.
The Rensselaer ruby.
That's right. The largest ruby in the world, stolen 3 years ago from the London Museum.
What a story.
Thanks to Kent here.
And to Superman.
Like I always say, two heads are better than one.
Any minute you'll be trying to tell me that I'm J. Edgar Hoover and you're Superman.
Could be.
That did it. Goodbye, Kent.
So long, Candy.
Well, Kent, looks like a party. What in blazes happened to you at the museum?
Oh, me?
Yeah, you just disappeared.
You know Clark, Inspector. He's always disappearing.
I'll bet you were hiding behind one of those wax figures.
Behind Superman, Chief.
Well, Chief, a lot of people think that Superman works for the planet. You're the editor.
Say, maybe they're smarter than we think. Maybe you're Superman.
Me in that outfit? Now look here, Kent.
Skip it. I've got a hunch. Like you said, Kent, I think they're trying to find out something about Superman. They started on Mr. White and the Olsen kid. But look, they've circled Miss Lane's name and yours here and here. Kent, I think you're the next man up.
Could be.
Don't worry, son. If they're up to something really big, they don't want you. They want Superman.
Six of one, a half a dozen of the other.
Clark, what are you doing here?
The chief decided it might take both of us to crack this story.
Oh, he did he?
But how did you get her so fast?
Jim, when I'm in a hurry to get someplace, I really fly.
Clark, what in the world are you doing?
Just fixing this sign. There. Doesn't that look better?
Well, how did you know?
That Alvin Godfrey was the monster, that he and his father conspired to steal the hydrazite deposits, and that you just phoned the story into the planet?
Well, how did you know? You weren't there.
A little bird told me. And if you're a good girl, someday I'll tell you who that little bird is. Now move over. I'll drive.
The prodigal son returns.
Hi, Mr. Kent.
Hiya, Jim. Hello, Miss White. Glad to see you safe and sound.
I'm glad to be safe and sound, Mr. Kent, I assure you.
Where have you been?
Port-au-Prince.
Port-au-Prince, eh? We came close to being crushed to death. We'd have all been killed if it hadn't have been for Superman.
Really?
Golly, you've never seen anything like it. The walls were closing in, and we would have all been crushed. But, Monsieur Kent, how did you get back here so quickly?
I flew.
I'm glad to see you finally come to your senses and cut out that crazy publicity gag.
Yeah, some gag.
And where were you during all this, if I may ask?
Me? I went fishing. Caught a big one, too.
Well, Clark, I told you if I got half a lead, I'd get the real story.
Lois, I'm glad you got the story. And I'm glad you didn't write anything in it about the effect of kryptonite on Superman.
That's one thing I'm never going to tell anybody.
That's too dangerous a thing for anyone else to know, even if there isn't any more kryptonite in the world.
Isn't it funny to think Superman actually has a weakness? It makes him seem almost human. For once, we had to save him.
Yes, we're all pretty lucky, I guess.
We? Now, don't tell me you're going to take credit for it.
Oh, I'm not, Lois. I'm definitely not. In fact, I'm not even human. Good evening.
And where have you been, Mr. Kent?
Me? Oh, I've been around.
Oh, around, eh? And I suppose you can explain why you and Superman have both been missing for approximately the same length of time?
My dear Miss Lane, don't you realize there's a logical explanation for everything?
All right, start getting logical.
Well, let's just say that Superman had certain things to do and I had certain things to do.
Such as?
Well, Superman had a hunch that if he exposed himself to the full fury of an electrical storm, it might neutralize the radiations he'd absorbed. Well, it worked.
Oh, it did, eh? And I suppose if Superman isn't radioactive anymore, you aren't either.
Me? Radioactive? I should say not. See? This is a Geiger counter. If I were radioactive, this gadget would be clicking away like mad.
And what are you doing with the Geiger counter?
Oh, well, Superman asked me to check this plane for any traces of contamination. Obviously, it's perfectly all right. See? No clicks.
You're just trying to confuse me. But Superman and you, I still wonder.
Wonder? Well, it's no wonder you wonder. You're a pretty wonderful girl.
Wait a minute. How do you know all that?
Oh, didn't I tell you? I have my memory back again now.
Really, Clark? Just because you got hit on the head is no sign that's what happened to Superman.
Why not? I think we have something in common. As a matter of fact, I know we do. You see, I know who he is now, too.
Oh, you do? Mm-hmm. Well, come on, who?
Oh, just knock me on the head sometime. You'll find out.
Mr. Kent, I'm really very glad you're well again. But I'm not so sure it's much of an improvement. Clark, do you suppose I could ask Mr. Kelso how you got out of the back of that truck?
But Lois, I've told you again and again. Superman smashed a hole in that truck and I went through it, and that's the absolute truth.
Look, Uncle Oscar, if I tell Mr. Kelso all I know about Superman, do you suppose he could actually figure who he is?
Oh, I don't know about that. Superman might not like it.
Besides, he might turn out to be someone very dull, like...
Oh, never mind. Don't you strain yourself thinking of something dull.
Kent!
Yes, sir.
Well, where is it?
Right here, sir.
When on earth do you have time to do all this?
Well, Chief, sometimes I can be pretty fast with that typewriter of mine.
Must be. Come in the office.
Yes, sir.
And you should have seen the look on Homer Garrity's face when it happened.
And how do you happen to know about the look on his face?
Yes, Kent, just how do you know that?
Well, I happened to be nearby at the time.
Oh, now don't tell me that I had a reporter at the scene of a story for a change.
Maybe he was nearer than you think, Chief. Come on, Jim.
Well, that should hold him till I can signal the Coast Guard.
Superman, what's the matter with you?
Here, Jim, you better hold this.
Superman, will you please get down there and save Mr. Kent?
I'll never forgive you if he drowns.
All right, I'm going. But I'm finished here, and I won't be back.
I don't care. Just save Clark.
Sure, Lois. Just a little wet, that's all. Why, are you worried?
Well, yes, I mean, Superman waited so long and...
Yes?
And you appeared right after he disappeared.
Oh, Lois, give me your hand, will you?
Oh, man!
What did you say you were thinking, Lois?
Never mind, Clark. It couldn't be. It just couldn't be.
What's your name, buddy?
Which one?
Well, how many do you have?
Several.
Let's just have one.
Lou. Lou Chambers.
Okay, Lou, step back. Next.
Glad to help out anytime, Inspector.
Hi, Dad.
Hello, son. Now, Kent, this is my son, Ray.
Yes, we met years ago. How are you, Ray?
Fine, Mr. Kent. Must be something big up to bring you around.
Oh, that attempted bank stick-up. I needed a few extras to fill in on the lineup. Say, you certainly acted the part. What was that business about having several names?
Oh, just something to say, I guess.
Well, all I've got to say is that Claude James is the man. Claude and Muscles McGurk.
Well, you can't find McGurk. And the bank teller won't identify James, is that right?
That, in a nutshell, is the situation, I'm afraid.
I'm sorry. I don't really believe in the things.
Say, I'll bet if Superman were here, he'd rub this horseshoe and make a magnet out of it and help us get out of here.
Superman would knock a hole through the wall, silly. Come on, we'll find a way out.
Trouble is, too many people might see him knocking that hole.
Well, I wish I could have been there. It sounds like it must have been pretty exciting.
Golly, look at the swell souvenir I got. The hatchet great horse used to chop the tree down.
I got one, too. A necklace from the claws of the bear.
Inspector, I think you'll find a lot of missing people in the basement of that house.
Where's Clark?
Yes, where is he?
Where he usually is. Excuse me.
Get off your side, whining gopher!
Whatever that is. Well, Jimmy, now you can get out of here.
My jeepers, thanks, Superman. How did you get here?
Same way I get everywhere.
No, I don't mean that. How did you know I was in jail?
Oh, I happened to overhear a conversation between Miss Lane and Mr. Kent.
Mr. Kent? Is he coming out here?
Yes, as a matter of fact, I expect him any minute now.
Jeepers, with both you and Mr. Kent here, I don't have anything to worry about.
Well, now, Jimmy, I can't stay. And incidentally, I want you to keep this a secret between you and me.
Whatever you say, Superman.
Thanks, Jimmy. I'll see you.
I just happen to have a deck of cards right handy.
Well, that's a coincidence.
A cigarette, Mr. Kent?
Well, thank you. No, I don't smoke.
Huh.
Can I light yours?
Well, sure. Thanks. You're a real nice man, Mr. Kent. Well, on fire! What happened?
Well, I'm awfully sorry. It must be my fault. I threw the match on there. I'm terribly sorry.
I'm gonna give you the benefit of the doubt. Deal.
Well, it's nice to be trusted. Let's see.
You know, I sort of got a feeling you might have played this game before.
Nonsense. All right, Gunner, what do you want to play for?
Match that.
All righty. That should cover it. Cut. Oh, I beg your pardon.
Mighty fancy deal, Mr. Kent.
Nothing. Nothing at all. All right, Gunner, how many cards?
I'm standing pat.
Well, so am I. You beat five aces?
Five. Well, it ain't more than four in the whole blame pack.
That is not what you said this morning when you had the five aces.
Yeah, but that... Well... Looks like you win, Mr. Kent.
Yes, looks like. Well, thanks for the lesson.
It's more intimate this way, no?
Yes.
Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Who are you?
My name is Clark Kent. I'm an American newspaper man.
He was at the airport. He came from America with Grigori.
How did you get in here?
No one tried to keep me out.
The palace is surrounded by guards. To get past one, one would have to fly over them.
Oh, come now. Surely you don't think I can fly?
Who dares to create such a disturbance? Bring the interloper before me. You know, Mr. Kent, sometimes Miss Lane actually thinks you're Superman. So why don't you just bust out of here?
Well, now, Jimmy, if I did that, you'd be sure, wouldn't you? Anyway, I want you all to go in this next room. I have a little idea. Come on. It may be a little dangerous, and I don't want anyone else to share it. Come on. Out we go. Thank you.
What's he doing?
It might be dangerous, he says. Since when is he such a hero?
Of course I could break out of here. Can you imagine the embarrassing questions?
Payday! Hey, hurry up and open yours, Jim. We got the raise.
Oh, am I going to celebrate tonight? I'm going to go to 2 double features.
Well, that's funny. I didn't get any raise.
Well, naturally. We help Superman round up the gang, not you.
That's right, Lois. I guess I wasn't much help, was I? Here I am, Jim.
Don't explain anything, Superman. I'm sure I wouldn't believe it.
Jeepers, Superman, I'm afraid you're too late. They've probably already done away with poor Mr. Kent.
Now, don't worry, Jimmy. It's true they did push him out of a plane, but fortunately I was there when he fell.
Poor Clark. I bet he was scared silly.
Oh, I wouldn't say that, Miss Lane. I thought he took it rather well. For Clark Kent, that is.
Now, you don't have anything on us. No witnesses.
No, I wouldn't be too sure of that. Well, the fireman's friends.
I can't get you, but I can shut him up.
Mr. White, will you call our friends, please? The police?
With pleasure, Superman. What's the matter? No wisecracks?
He'll have a long time to think up some new ones where he's going.
Well, get me the police, please. I wonder what Clark Kent will have to say when I show up with this story.
Well, strangely enough, I don't think he'd be surprised. Hi, Lois.
Well, hi, Rover boy. Where have you been?
Oh, out working as usual. What are you writing?
Oh, nothing. Nothing at all.
For someone that's doing nothing, nothing at all, you're making an awful lot of racket about it.
Well, if you must know, and I suppose you must, I'm writing the story of Superman's capture of Schultze Garfield. As usual, you missed it.
I see. Well, you can only be one place at a time, you know, Lois.
The least you could have done was thrown me a rope.
But I told you, Miss Slater, I didn't have one. They took it with them.
I ache all over, especially the top of my head.
Well, perhaps the little raise you'll get for a good story will help that ache a bit.
Collie, what great liniment. Do I get a little too?
Oh, I suppose so. By the way, where were you when this story was breaking?
To me, Chief? Why, I was practicing the levitation trick.
Well, in that case, maybe you should have come along. Superman might have taught it to you.
Why, Lois, what a wonderful idea. As a matter of fact, I think he did.
However can I thank you?
Please don't try, sir. Miss Lane?
Golly, Superman, you flew all the way across the ocean to rescue them. I sure wish Clark Kent were here to see this.
Yes, where is Kent anyway?
Oh, you know Clark. He never shows up till everything is over with.
That's right.
Oh, now, Miss Lane, I wouldn't exactly say that. You wouldn't expect Kent to get around as fast as I do, would you? I think I'll just pay a little call on Mr. Pebble. If he is Pebble, he won't have a metal plate in his head. If he's Dobie, or Pebble and Dobie, he will.
How are you going to find out? Hit him on the head to see if it rings, or use your X-ray vision like Superman?
Well, one way or the other, Bill, one way or the other. Want to come along?
No, thanks. I've got a date with the commissioner. But keep me informed, would you?
Oh, I sure will. I want to find out a little bit more about that mine myself.
You see, Clark, you have no reason to fear Mr. McTavish.
Oh, I'm sure you're right, Lois. After all, it was Superman who was in danger.
Well, we surely owe our lives to Superman. All of us.
We certainly do, don't we, Clark?
Well, all I can say is if it weren't for Superman, I wouldn't be here.
Well, now that that's settled, suppose you two go out and start writing the story for the next edition.
Including my dream?
Definitely not.
Let's face it, Jimmy. Like I said, none of us will ever be able to do the things Superman does.
I guess not.
But
golly, Mr. Kent, you'll never know how wonderful it is to be like Superman.
No, Jimmy, I guess I never will.
Don't miss the next thrill-packed episode in the amazing adventures of Superman. Superman is based on the original character appearing in Superman magazine.